guests. It's a great pleasure for me to be here. I would like to start congratulating those godfathers and people who have decided on this project. I can imagine what a pleasure to see that something what you worked on, what you fought on, is actually materializing. So it's a tribute to you that project is really happening. It is entering, or I should say, entered an irreversibility phase, and this project will happen. I would like to thank the Commission for arbitrating on the project between primarily three Baltic states. And I would like to encourage Baiba Rubesa to keep strength in what she is doing, because it's probably easier to be a mouse between three cats than Baiba Rubesa between three Baltic states. You have a tough job, but slowly and surely we're becoming a believers of this project, and we're picking up your enthusiasm, and as you showed here, that it will probably change each and single bit of our lives with Rail Baltica. I'm not sure if that would be effect of that magnitude. But with projects, mega projects like this, you never know what benefits it will ultimately bring. I bet that there are benefits which we have never thought of and we can't think of now, because with infrastructure like this, our eyes will be opened, our minds will be opened, and we'll see more opportunities. Three Baltic states, after leaving Soviet Union, were in all infrastructure very much integrated towards eastwards, towards Russia. And our fight for independence, not only political but practical independence, is also a fight in rebuilding our infrastructure. The same is happening in energy, the same is happening in transportation. And this project is another project which will strengthen our countries. And I'm very happy that we found power, we found will to cooperate, because there are many skeptics who are discussing who will benefit most of this project and so on and so forth. But those questions are too early. First we need to build, and then we need to think. Then we'll see what benefits it will bring. At least this is the way we're in Lithuania thinking. So I hope, I hope, and I'm sure, right? I should say I'm sure, that after we'll build it, we'll realize how big potential it brought to us. As current transportation flows in our countries goes from east to west in three Baltic states, and that's a big difference between the rest of European countries. That's a big difference. That will be a game changer, a mind changer. And I encourage my colleagues from Latvia and Estonia already to start working with our colleagues in Finland, with our colleagues in Poland, maybe down to Germany, to Netherlands, already to start promoting this route. Yes, Rail Baltica is not there, but rail route is already there. So we should already start promoting this track. This possibility, when it will be opened up, it will just strengthen a business proposal which we might have already to our European colleagues. On Lithuania, things are progressing well. As it was mentioned before, part of the track is already constructed up to the Kaunas. We have started land expropriation north towards Latvian border. Landowners are already informed. We have started discussions with the farmers, because farmers would be mostly affected with land expropriation. A certain compensation scheme according to law exists, so I believe that when things will run well. To sum it up, I would like to thank Commission first of all for, as I said, for arbitrating, because without your help, and of course without your financing, this project will never happen. So your role is crucial here, and please make believers out of us more and more with every day which will pass. Thank you very much.